All right, here you go. So I'm going to do a little video on how to remove this bushing housing for you right here. So as we already talked on the phone, you got to remove this cover. But you said you had something for your kid's toy, so I'm assuming it's a Phillips or flathead. As when you look at that screw, you better tell it's a Phillips. All right. So basically, you need to replace this. So what you're going to do is this is your Allen. The most important thing is don't try and turn this by the Allen. Turn it by the bolt underneath here with your socket set, because this could possibly strip, and it's hard to be, I don't know how strong you are, but it's hard to be strong enough to turn it by this. So use this for holding, this for turning, all right? So mine's been done a couple of times, so it's gonna be easier than yours. So this is gonna be harder, okay? So you're just gonna crank that off right there. And those bolts are usually on there pretty tight. It won't come like that unless you get real lucky. But this is super simple, but just physically hard to do. So you're just gonna remove that, and that's really about it on that. Now, sometimes this is hard to pull off, so I forgot to add one tool at the beginning. Just take a screwdriver, get it started, and then usually it pulls off pretty easy, all right? So this is what you need your other socket head for. I'm gonna take that in here like this. See, mine's a lot easier than what yours. Don't go by what mine is for yours. I've taken this stupid thing apart 1,000 times. Okay, so there's your new part. Only replace, I know I sent you two. I did that by accident. So only replace the one that you have a problem with, because it's just too much work. And that way you have the other part kind of as a spare if you ever need it, all right? This is not preventative work. This is repair work. So it doesn't really help you to do it ahead of time. All right, so then it's better off to keep that part as a spare part. I usually turn everything by hand. Then lightly tighten it down some. You want to make sure it can still swivel. All right, then take your arm, which came off really easy. Yours will not. And slide that bad boy just like that. Mine has washers. Make sure you keep the washers. Doesn't matter too much, though. And then you're just going to retighten that bolt. So it's super simple to do, but it's not necessarily physically easy to do. Mine is only because I've taken it off a few times. And that is it. So if you still have a problem with your leg jumping off, sometimes tightening this down too tight can make it do that. Sometimes this too loose can make it do that. But your model doesn't call for the rails, so you're going to have to work out your problem between this and the connection right here. That's why we sent you this. All right? Thanks a lot.